Fintech Nation. It is day 32 of the challenge, approaching that halfway point. And my clicker's dead. I doubt you care. You shouldn't really care. It's not a big deal. I'll get a new clicker. All right. Listen, I thought I'd beat this one to death, but it's been brought up again. Heart rates for HIIT not coming down between intervals. Okay, they probably won't. So again, I'm just going to tell you, really your lower heart rate and your upper heart rate, that's really the, so whatever you're doing for your cardio, so let's just say it's bike, you're going to warm up for 10 minutes, right? Because that's what you're supposed to do, is warm up for 10 minutes. And you're going to get your heart rate to that lower number. So whatever intensity, whatever gear you have it on the bike, that's the gear you will use in between your intervals. Okay? And then whatever gear you have to take it to get to that higher heart rate, that's what you'll do when you start your interval, okay? And then hopefully by the end of the interval, you get your heart rate up to that point. What happens between intervals? Those 40 seconds, those 40 to 45 seconds, you're not gonna get your heart rate down unless you are a super endurance athlete, okay? So don't worry about that. Just simply go to the same intensity as you did on your warm-up between your intervals, okay? So for that 40 to 45 seconds, just go at the same intensity that you did your warm-up, okay? And ignore the fact that your heart rate doesn't come down to your lower level, okay? So don't worry about that. Okay, now we are into the week that you will not quit. I just want to remind you all, and I want to remind you that you will not quit at any point going forward, right? Right. Okay, I just want to throw that out there. And we'll get back to that in a sec. Okay, I want to talk a little bit more about sugar. So, I didn't answer all the questions that were asked to me regarding sugar. So I'm just gonna answer them now. I may have answered them already, but I'll be a little bit more direct in my answers, short and direct. So what is the acceptable amount of sugar to have in a day? Well, you wanna have somewhere between 20 and 40 grams of fiber, okay? In your diet per day, okay? So let's just say you have 20 grams, okay? And you have 200 grams of carbs. You have up to 180 grams of sugar you can have. Okay? Now when I say sugar, that means starch and simple sugars, right? Because like I mentioned yesterday, starch is just a chain of sugars, okay? You can think of starch as a sugar, okay? We don't call it that, but it really is just a chain of sugar. Starch is broken down into sugar, okay? So just think of it like that. So just try to make sure you get your fiber, which you should if you're eating all real whole food. I haven't pushed you guys on this, but if you're eating real whole food, you should be, like minimally processed foods, you should be getting a decent amount of fiber, especially if you're eating fruits and vegetables, okay? But it doesn't have to be just fruits and vegetables, okay? There are certain breads and things like oatmeal and brown rice, these types of things, yams, okay, that are higher in fiber. Okay. All right. So, let's talk about, okay, let me ask this one more question, actually. If this person says, if I had 10 grams of sugar, do I remove 10 grams of carbs? Well, the sugar is carbs, right? Which we went through that yesterday. So I think by now you probably understand that, yeah, that would be part of your carb allotment. So yes, you would remove 10 grams because you had 10 grams of carbs. Okay, now if you enter, remember, you're entering everything into your app, so your app's gonna tell you this. Okay, your app's gonna tell you, it's going to give you the total amount of carbs you had for the day. Okay, and you can look in more detail at the types of carbs that you're having if you're curious. And again, the only thing that you would wanna be concerned with here is obviously your total amount of carbs, but also your fiber, right? Okay, so let me just talk a little bit about why is sugar so bad? Like, why does sugar get a bad name? Like, why not just have sugar? We can have carbs, what's the big deal? Okay, really the problem with sugar is this. When you have enough of it, especially of simple sugar, and you don't have anything else with it, okay, and it's not post-exercise, then your body doesn't really have a need for all of that sugar at one time, okay? So what do I mean by this? I mean that if you have a bunch of simple sugar, it gets digested very fast and your blood sugar levels go up, and then your body says, I need to get rid of the sugar because I can't, it's toxic to your body to have high blood sugar levels, right? So what your body will do, if you're a healthy, normal individual and you don't have diabetes, it will release insulin from your pancreas, and that insulin will shuttle that sugar somewhere. It will either go to your liver, or it will go to your muscles, or most likely, unless you just did a ton of exercise, it will go to body fat. It will. And in fact, body fat has the most insulin receptors on it. In fact, body fat, your fat cells, are your savior, really. Because if it wasn't for your fat taking in that sugar, okay, and that's not exactly how it works, but just for simplicity, if it wasn't for your fat taking in that sugar, you would die, okay? So thankfully, we can have, you know, ample amounts of sugar and get fat, or else we would die, okay? So this is why we wanna avoid the sugar. Now also, you know, we wanna avoid one of the fastest growing chronic lifestyle diseases out there, which is diabetes, type 2 diabetes to be specific. And this is all a result of what I believe are two things. One, the amount of carbohydrates we eat, and two, the amount of screen time, okay? Our lifestyles are very, you know, like we're pretty lazy, okay? We're definitely doing less these days because we're on a screen more often, all right? So those are the two main reasons. And yet, although things are slowly changing, you know, we're told to avoid protein, okay? Or keep protein low and not to have too much fat. So it's like, okay, so all my calories are gonna come from carbohydrates. Great, awesome, okay. And we see diabetes skyrocketing. If you don't believe me, just look it up, okay? It was 10 years ago, the fastest, 8 years ago, it was the fastest growing chronic disease. One of the fastest. It was the fastest. In fact, 8 years ago, it was predicted that if it kept growing at the rate that it's growing, that it will wipe out the US medical system. That one disease alone will wipe out the US medical system by the year, I think they said 2030. So, you know, we gotta eat a little more protein and fat, okay? We need to exercise more too, okay? Maybe not you specifically, but I'm just talking in generalities, especially the American population. Okay, that's all I'm gonna say. So message of the day is this. The only way one can fail is to quit. That's the only way. That's the only way you will fail. Because I guarantee you, you will move ahead at somewhat. You'll definitely move ahead further. You'll definitely move ahead further if you don't quit, as compared to if you did quit. Because if you do quit, that means you're doing nothing. And if you don't quit, that means you're doing something. And that something is going to move you somewhere, all right? So you need to persevere and keep going and keep trying and not give up. And please remember that things are continuing to change for you in this challenge. And it's not just about those numbers that I give you, and it's not just about the amount of exercise that you're doing, but it's about you evolving and learning more and making more progression and learning how to be, you know, learning how to do these movements better, learning how to feel your body and make your body work, okay? Not to mention, it's the accumulation of everything you're doing over time that builds some momentum for you, okay? All right, that's all I'm gonna say. Submit, commit, positive energy, positive vibes. Believe in yourself, and as always, give some gratitude. I will talk to you guys all very soon. I'm looking for my clicker, but I don't need my clicker because it's busted. I'll see you all soon. What are we today? We're Tuesday, right? So class is tonight, class is Thursday. Maybe we'll open up some more. By now you should know we have a 9 a.m. class, which there's still, by the way, there's still many spaces for this class. So, you know, make sure you come on out. I'll talk to you guys all very soon. See ya.